24 minutes. Let's just take it slow. It doesn't matter if we win or not. It's gonna be year number 4 next. Yeah, basically Deus Ex. The first one. The controls are bad. Of course, the game is great. The first time I installed the game, right? Which I might. Oh, why are you kicking me? Which I might or might have not installed it. Whatever. You know how it is when you're like 15 years old. Anyway, so I installed this game, started playing it, and back at the day, back then I was all about, like, you have to understand that, you know, I started out my, wow, this car is really a lot faster than me. Oh, I'm limited. What class is that? I was fourth, which is not bad. I don't know where to brake, I don't have experience with this. Oh, I crap, I didn't check why my video stuttering. Well, this is a place where I turtle. No, it's not. Wait. Alright, you know what? I can't really do anything about this right now. About the stuttering, but I can close all my windows in my browser. Which hopefully decrease the laggability off the recording. I mean, Firefox eats a lot of resources. There's no doubt about that. I totaled my car like on the straight or something. So yeah. Anyway, continuing with my Deus Ex story. I installed it, and back in the day I played pretty much games which were, you'd consider them pro gaming games. I really started my gaming with Quake 2 and Carmageddon. Don't forget Carmageddon. But yeah, it mostly was Quake 2. We played a lot of Quake 2, and then it was Counter-Strike and StarCraft Brood War. This is when I was, so you can imagine that, you know, those games are pinnacle of what a pro gaming game should be. 6 hours, yeah, sure. You know, the response time, and you know, the mouse is so precise, and the response time is just so fast, so crisp. You know, there isn't, like, you can never blame game physics for a, well, probably game physics, but not in that way, in like Quake or whatever. In those games that I listed, they are phenomenal. There is no doubt about that. But when it came to Deus Ex, and you know, like, you have to understand, I was like 15, so you know, it's a big deal when you're 15 to feel superior to everyone else. And so I was like, this game is trash. It's imprecise. You know, the mouse isn't like, you know, I can't 360 no scope people here. This game sucks. So I started playing it. I liked back then, you know, the environment and everything like that. I mean, I definitely saw already something in the game, but for me it wasn't completely unacceptable the way, you know, the game is. It was handling. And another thing too. Why am I going left to right? No, I can break even later than what was it, 150? I could have really picked up a lot of money here if I completed the sponsorship challenge, but that's not gonna happen. I don't even know why people would give me money to race for them. I'm clearly a noob. My biggest result is like what, a podium in Skip Barber series, let's say. Probably Formula like 4. Anyway, I don't actually remember why did I pick up, like, when I picked up Deus Ex, I was already an adult. I don't remember why I picked it up. I guess it's just the hype, you know, people say it's a good game, so I picked it up. Played it, absolutely loved it, it was fantastic. It's not like, I don't think it's the same, on the same level as the same Mass Effect. I just don't, I'm sorry. Or Last of Us or whatever. But it's a fantastic game. I even enjoyed the second Deus Ex, if you remember. Invisible War. People disliked it, but I really enjoyed the game. In fact, for me, it was more memorable, I think, than the first one. I think when people like, well, not when people like. I think if all, you know, like, whenever I think about Deus Ex, the memories that come to me from the second one. And for some reason, I think some of them are from Castle Wolfenstein. I think there is a level in Deus Ex Invisible War that is similar to Castle Wolfenstein. Once again, to first core developer of iRacing. Look at those transitions. Oh no. I thought I could do it. Crap. I'm gonna have to limp around now. My steering is messed. Cannot go fast. I'm gonna have to, like, this lap will take me 9 minutes. Let me see options. Yeah, I don't know. I, for some reason, I felt such a level of. Such a level of downforce that I thought I could take them both flat out. But by the time I saw that I couldn't, I was already so late. So here is 9 minutes of it. Anyway, yeah, I think there is a level in Deus Ex Invisible War that is similar to some kind of old timey French village or something. I want my money, that's why I'm going for it. Wait, it's not 24 minutes, it's a lie. This race is not 24 minutes. I'm just looking at the recording and I'm like, yeah, this is going fast. And I'm looking at the recording and I'm like, it's been only 9 minutes. They cut a 24 hour race to 24 minutes. At least when I race and start doing this, it was 2.5 hours for 24 races. And they still cannot even do it like proper. I think it's probably halved, so it's like 12 minutes. Well, that's good. That means you don't have to do this for 9 minutes. We're gonna get lapped. I wonder if I need to cross the finish line. Yep. Oh, are we? Maybe we can crash on the other side. Maybe if we do it like this, poof, it will even out. We're not helping our case by going this way. We're just making things worse. Yeah. Actually, it does feel a little bit better. Oh no. Can't even crash on. Oh no. Crap. Well, that was a waste of time, everybody. I apologize. Pedro Lamy said. It's also a real race.
This is going to be your best season yet. I got a good feeling about it. Don't you think we should start signing new sponsors who bring in more money?
Please, woman. Alright, let's do this one, I guess. Since we haven't really done it. No, I think after this series we'll take a break. Dirtiest car. Yeah, I know. I only know Brian Townsend, he's a poker professional. I don't think he's from Canada, but I'm not 100% to be honest. For some reason I thought that Brian was from around my area, New York area. It's not really helping me. What I gain, it's like one step forward, two step backwards. I'm not feeling this. Not feeling this for sure. Maybe like this. But right rear wheel, bro. Maybe this is the best. Feels fast, but that's good, sort of good. Now it's Dan Gurney. What? The inventor of the Gurney flap? Doing my personal world record, yo. I still haven't looked at the lag that's in my recordings. That's a mistake. Maybe it's not a recordings, maybe just a. I think that car got damaged or something. Well, that was surprising. Yeah, I didn't see him in a. I sort of expected him in a small. Why do I need to pretend that I enjoy a little bit of. That I don't enjoy a little bit of crashing, pushing people out of my way? I do, absolutely do. Guilty. I am guilty. What the hell? I just killed so many people. It's unbelievable. No, I'm last now. Crap. I've been like what? All these must die. Don't you think that that part where I hit him with my tail was unintentional? 100% intentional. I'm a dirty driver. Oh, fuck, stop it. Sort of like all the city tracks they have look similar, like at least in GT5, GT6 they're different, but here they really just, you know, those big spinny things, they all make them like look like Rome and Gran Turismo. I mean, as far as I understand, that's how it actually is. They actually did, like in Gran Turismo, they actually used actual street layout for their plans. Wow, I'm so far. So, you know, roundabouts and stuff, yeah, it's very European in nature. Now it's not me, they crash into me. What was that? Am I gonna be on a podium? Please don't mess it up, it would be awesome. It would be awesome. Why is there no brakes? I'm like fully depressing it. Is there no ABS in these cars? I mean, it's an old Mustang, there is no ABS there, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I think there is no ABS here. It's pretty advanced. 2 seconds is a lot, especially if you suck like me. Okay, boss man. You got some damage to your radiator. Don't mess it up, boss man. Again, I'm just thinking they have ABS and pressing fully. And just doesn't stop at all. Now I'm pressing it halfway and it's alright. Just stop. Remember, don't press it fully, don't lock your brakes. See? The difference is huge. I guess they do have like realistic. Well, we respect them for this, I guess. It's more or less realistic handling. Or rather, not realistic, but. Don't talk to me through the straights. Oh my god, this guy just cost me. This guy just cost me a podium, what an asshole. I think he blew his engine. Maybe there is a chance. No. I forgot that I cannot jam the brakes. I'm on the podium. Maybe I should level up. I said it was be my last, but I feel like maybe I should level up. sponsors who bring in more money. All right, how do I? Oh, is that what she was complaining about? That I'm not using both of them. I said it was per slot. Like this slot to choices, that's a slot to choices. All right, let's buy a car. You need a car. All right, let's remember. 2.5, 3.5, 3.5. Hope I remember it. Now let's buy the super. This is the winningest one, right? 20. All right, let's. I can't afford this. Oops. How much money do I have? 80k. All right. 3.5. No, the same stats. Does winning change anything? I mean, I thought that was the point. Oh, if you buy a good one that won a lot of races, it'll be boosted or something. I'm still rich. I'm a sucky driver. This isn't like real life at all. Donington. But I'm doing better now. I mean, I'm not winning, but at least I got what, like 2 podiums. Not with those assholes driving though. Maybe like this. It's pretty weird, to be honest. I mean, I think I've already said that, but. Oh no. Oh no. I saw weird, I don't like any of the cameras. This is a Mamon Haitian. Sometimes I just like to change cameras like that. Just change them around and shit. Yeah, and here this one does seem like it has ABS in there. Although when I play, well, obviously when I play iRacing, there is no option to change the view. But when I play Assetto Corsa, I have the same view, like realistically inside the car. So it's especially fun for me to go outside of the car. Like, obviously, you know, higher vintage point does provide certain benefits. Although being low down and having the sense of speed is also important. But I guess, you know, even from a bird eye or whatever, you would eventually learn to judge the sense of speed correctly. But yeah, there is also obvious, you know, drawbacks to everything. You know, from my experience, I think from experience of majority people who play more or less realistic simulators / arcades like Forza or GT6, GT5, like I think most would say that the best is on top of again. On top of hood, sort of like low enough. It's not even higher. It's not higher. Maybe being in the cockpit is the best. What the? I think it's my stick. Oh well, I'm about to be last again. Maybe not actually. I'm sort of slow. Anyway, yeah. Sort of the same height, so maybe cockpit height is pretty good height for a car. Probably Formula One cars are a bit like if you saw the Degrassi video, Degrassi view video, I don't think it's entirely accurate, to be honest. But it is probably the most accurate we'll ever get. Well, with current technology anyway. Yeah, I can't really see much there. So it's probably is better to be like in a slightly higher level. Probably, you know, all those cars that are like from Senna time, which you sit in a car rather than, you know, lie down, but you're still very low to the track, they probably combine the best visibility / feeling of speed for a driver. But yeah, when you're in a cockpit, inside the cockpit like that, you still have somewhat obstructed view by all the A-pillars and stuff. I wanted to use this because A pillar is just basically car have pillars, like first pillar is the one that holds your windshield, second pillar is the one that holds your door and so on. A, B, C, D. Wow. There are a lot of people spinning. I wonder if it's like intentional behavior to give players a chance to randomize it, because it's definitely fun. Like for me it's very important. I don't really like simulators like I never raced really in Gran Turismo, for example, because partially because when I was playing it I wasn't actually good at any racing game, so it sort of was practicing, but also partially because I mean after I got good, after I practiced, no not good, whatever, I got all right, have some 250 finishes, it's high up in rating, high-ish. Whoa, holy shit, so lucky the guys who spun way behind me. Anyway, it feels first of all unfair that, you know, someone who crashes their car, drives their car like shit or whatever, is not punished. And second of all, when I started playing racing, just so entertaining to see who's gonna survive and who's not. I mean, obviously, it's very harsh to have it like in real life, where, you know, sometimes even through no fault, like last year's Le Mans, you know, sometimes bad things happen to good people. That's that kind of stuff. So, you know, I wouldn't want a simulator where everything is as harsh as in real life. But I definitely would want some kind of punishment. And as well, you know, I think it's also important to include how you drive engine. I mean, like, it's a skill, you know, people like Prost or Jenson Button are famed for being gentle in their cars. So I think it is important to include and reward that kind of driving as well. But, you know, like, because right now in all the games, you're more rewarded for Senna-esque like driving than you are for Prost like driving. And it was alright. It was better than the first. crap, I need so much more. Alright, I actually enjoyed this little sight again. Sixth podium. So I understand that one podium is rookie when I won, the other podium is BMW when I was on the car on track. It's Jarama, right? How the hell did we have two races in Dankton? So it's just random two races in Dankton, I suppose? I thought it was like some kind of, because the TVR is British car, it was like some kind of Dankton showdown. And it's like people, there is like a saying or whatever in the simulator world. Like in when you go to when you learn a real track, when you learn a real car, you start out slow and then you go faster. Because obviously going too fast and crashing damages your car, costs money, can kill you. That was very modern. Like way I said that, but in simulators it usually is the other way around. You go find the fastest you cannot go, and then you gradually slow down from there to when where you can go. And at first I thought that it was just me, and I thought, yeah, you want to push the outer limit and then reel yourself back in. I thought that was just my approach, but then I went into some practice sessions with some top level guys who do the Grand Prix series, like De Jong, stuff like guys like that. And De Jong is probably the best guy I ever been in one single session with. He's really good. Like I've been some, you know, the iRacing World Championship series guys. But never one of those who like, never a race winner, I think. And De Jong is I think he's a race winner. He definitely can be capable. I mean, he's a professional, like he's very young, but he's also a professional driver in real life. So he actually is pretty busy. He missed, like he's, oh crap, this sucks. He has missed some iRacing championship races because he was busy with real life commitments. You know, like a guy of his caliber and like has no, like to see that he's oh my god, I'm just like something on my door. I feel like something happened to my car. I mean, it doesn't say anything, but I definitely feel like your left rear wheel is beginning to show signs of fatigue. I crushed it. Crap, I was doing so well. At least I'm not gonna be last. Never say never though. Yeah, I mean, like for someone of Dijon caliber to be missing iRacing, you can win 10 grand in iRacing championship. That's a lot of money. one better than last time. Although, to be honest, Dejong hasn't been doing so hot after that, but he's very new to the game. Wait, is it just the kind of like... Wait, what track are we on now? Is it still Jarama? Wow. Got to tap Windows message again. Please update to Windows 10. Fucking guy! Ping-ponged me into the wall. I'm sorry, I need to take a break. I mean, I have to do some stuff like that. The guy disappointed me, honestly. So, thanks for watching. I'll be back, maybe not today, it's like today. Monday.